One of the hardest parts of losing weight is eating smaller portions. In the last 30 years in the US, our portion sizes have grown considerably, sometimes doubling or more in size. Many of us don't even realize what a normal or suggested portion is. Today's portions are so large that we have portion distortion. Let's take a look. 20 years ago, a bagel looked like this. It was about 3 inches in diameter and provided 140 calories. Today, most bagels have doubled in size and calories. Next, let's take a look at a cheeseburger. Most restaurant cheeseburgers were much smaller 20 years ago in size and calories that they provided. Today, they are significantly larger and, of course, providing more calories. Finally, let's take a look at a serving of soda. 20 years ago, soda came in a 6.5 ounce bottle. This is still common in many countries around the world, but in the US, we drink soda like we should be drinking water, in large bottles. The typical serving size today contains many calories, and we know that these sugary calories are especially bad for our bodies when it comes to promoting weight gain. So why does it matter if portion sizes of foods are bigger? It matters a lot, because research has shown time and time again that if we are served a larger portion, we will eat more. So this can be good if the food is broccoli, but as we have just seen, the portions are usually of higher calorie foods that are often not very healthy for us, like bagels, pizza, and tubs of buttery popcorn. It seems logical then for us to eat smaller portions of higher calorie foods. Even healthy foods like nuts and seeds need to be eaten in moderation, or the calories will add up quickly in high numbers. This might work out fine if you're training for a marathon or trying to gain weight, but that's not the case for most of us. One caution is that our bodies can get used to eating larger portions of food, and then when we try to reduce them, we feel hungry and unsatisfied with the total amount of food we eat. The solution to this is to eat larger portions of healthier foods that are naturally lower in calories and higher in fiber, like fruits, and especially non-starchy vegetables, like leafy green vegetables, broccoli, cauliflower, green beans, asparagus, peppers, and carrots. A few other tips to decrease portion sizes are: eat at home more often. Restaurant portions are usually large enough to feed at least 2 people. When eating out, split the meal. When eating higher calorie foods like hamburgers or pizza, try to eat about half or maybe 75% as much as you usually do, and have a large side salad or vegetables to help fill you up. Eat off of smaller plates and bowls. Give yourself permission to go back for seconds, but wait 5 to 10 minutes after you finish your first portion. Read food labels. You may eat more than the serving size, but it will give you an idea of what a standard serving is. So let's remember, too large a portions can lead to large waistlines. However, with some of these simple changes, you can change how your portions affect you and lose weight.